Okay, we're going to take this switch out of the wall. It wasn't in there very tight. We're going to see how they did hooking this up. Okay, it's just a black and a white. You put tape on the black wire. I'll take our tester and make sure there's no power up here. Oh, the wires are around the screw the right way, but he didn't quite close the loop all the way on this. So I'll pull all this tape off. And this wire wasn't around the screw very well, so it wasn't a very good connection there. I'll take this one off. It's not under the head there, see? We'll take this off here because we don't need this clamp in here, so that'll give us more room in our box so we can fold our wires in without forcing them. See how much extra room that takes up? And we'll look at our ground wire, how we did it. That doesn't look too bad. Clip off all this extra ground wire he had down there. I'll open this loop up here. And yank all this tape off. It doesn't want to come off easy, you just pull it off the hard way like that, get it all off. You don't want any junk getting in under the into the connection. Okay, it's all mutilated. See how mutilated the wire is there? When I bend it, it's going to break right in there. See? Bad spot. So I'm going to just clip this back. Same with this one. Here in the country I was born in, we use a 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps, and this happens to be 12 American wire gauge. Okay, so we'll use our flathead screwdriver here. We'll make sure our ground wire is around the screw tight. It's nice and tight, and the copper is under the head all the way around. Okay, we'll turn our switch around. Now I'll reach back in the box here and grab all this paper out of here that was in here, because that you don't want paper build left in here. This is was wrapped around the older cloth wires, or the cloth on between the outer cloth and the vinyl on the inside. Okay, now since this is a single pole switch, it doesn't matter which screw you put them on. make sure it's nice and tight. And we'll do the black wire here, make our loop the traction our screw turns. Okay, there we go. We'll push this back into our box. We'll push our white going up and our black going down. And we'll keep our ground wire over on this side so it stays away from everything. We'll push our wires into the box. Tight here in the country I'm born in, down is off, up is on. If you put the switch in upside down, it would say on there, or no rather than off. Okay, I'll bring turn the camera a little bit this way. Okay, we'll look behind the switch, see what's going on this one. Wires are so short. Take the tape off the side of the switch, see if we have any power in here. Nothing, 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 nothing. And again, this switch is wired after the light. Let's see how nicely they made the loops. So those wires are very, very short. And they just hooked the ground wire around a screw in the back of the box, and there's no ground wire in this box. Okay, so we're gonna pigtail these here. Okay, I do see a ground wire in there, but it's very, very short, and it's going to one green screw back here. So we're going to take, and we're going to put another screw down here. Since the box is a conductor, We will put another screw here in the back. There's a hole for it. Okay, I'll take a wire we'll use for our ground tail. I'll make a loop like this, and I'll bend it like that so we can get it around the screw and close the loop. So we get it around the screw in the back, we'll close it up. Okay, now we'll make our tails to hook our switch back up again. Because these are going to be too short to put around the screws of the light switch. I'll just clip this one slightly shorter, not much, just a tiny smidgen. Okay, we'll strip our copper here about the same length as the wire that we're pigtailing to. Okay, that's both the same length. Now I'm not going to twist these because I don't want to break the copper. So I'm going to put our wire in here. I'm going to make sure they're even. So I'm going to hold my tail here. Make sure it's nice and tight. Okay, now fold this back into our box. Okay, now we'll do our other wire here. Now make sure they're about the same length again. Okay, I'm going to take a smidgen off. Okay, they're the same length. Okay, so I'll get them lined up so they're even here. Put our wire nut in here. We'll just turn it. It moves, so I'm going to hold it here. Get straight. Get them even. Now I'm going to hold my tail so it doesn't get moved and become crooked inside the wire nut. Okay, we got it twisted together there. Push our wires. I'm gonna look underneath these and make sure our insulation's going up into the bottom, which it is. And look at our other one here. Yep, they're in underneath the inside the cap there where we want them. There we go. Now we can hook our switch back up. Okay, these are still real long, so I'll shorten them up some here. Okay, I'll make my loop the direction our wire goes around the screw. Close it the direction our screw turns. Okay, we'll turn it around. Doesn't matter which one goes where because it's just a single pole switch and it's wired after the light. Okay, we gotta get that wire under the screw head like that. Make sure our insulation's not getting pinched. Okay, I make sure our copper is all the way under the head all the way around. Our insulation's not under the screw head. And we have a nice connection. Now we can fold our wires into the box. I'll fold our white up, black up, and our white down and keep our ground going across the bottom here. Keep it down on the bottom here. Push this bag out the wall. Okay, I'll just make sure our ground wire is down away from everything, and that is how to properly wire light switches here in the country I was born in. Peace. Thanks for watching.